Good evening, folks. Welcome to tonight's game between the Memphis Tigers and the Tulsa Hurricanes. And, of course, we look here at our Star Watch. And there are the starting lineups for each team.
The matchup at the small forward position should be entertaining. Two good young men who up and turn some head at the wing position.
And it's time for the tip-off.
Tips up and the game is on, baby.
And we'll get a change of possession. They've got him trapped here, Dick.
Hey, they got him in some trouble, Brad.
Dumps it in. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
He rejects it. Here they go in transition. And had his shot blocked. Here they come now on a turnover. Both teams looking to get things going here. And our trifecta for the Knights. Aaron Andrews on the sideline with Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. In the lane. Missed it. Tries for two. Drains it. Well, you know, basketball is like nutrition, Dick. His game to be broken down into the two major food groups, and that's passing and score.
Tell you, Brad, he can get an easy 8 assists a game or put up 15 to 20 points on any given night. A well-rounded player who has a good feel for the game.
There they come with a double team to stop it. Jeffrey picks up the foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad foul right there, Brad.
Number 15 receives the ball. He shoots the jumper and come up short. The crowd begins to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
That's good.
That's a breakdown. That'll drive a coach bananas. Help you to lose your hair.
That trap could spell some trouble. He escapes the trap.
That trap didn't scare him, Brad.
He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and on the move, and he does it exceptionally well.
Ellis receives the pass. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Missed the jumper.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. How about that drive to the hoop, Dick?
I'll tell you, he's really attacking the goal. He's going in fearless, and he's absolutely attacking the defense.
On the outside. Fadeaway. Bust the fadeaway, Jay.
Got to think right now. Got to focus defensively.
Might be a ball screen here, Dick.
Well, you got to use that screen. Hey, how the dribbler uses the screen is important in a pick-and-roll situation.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, it's a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
They've got him trapped. Number five comes up with it for two. off the glass and no good.
They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
Jumper won't go. Looking for a good shot. Jumper can't connect. We're at the six-minute mark. Pushes it up. Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. And now the fadeaway jumper. He's not getting himself in position for the good shot.
Yeah, it's a little bit too much. One-on-one.
Not this time. Power forward receives the pass. Takes the jumper. Nails the jumper. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. They work it around the perimeter.
Bad decision there by the freshman.
The shooting guard handles the pass. Off the mark. Goes up for two. Sinks it. Wow, what a finish on that back cut.
When the defense plays too aggressive, those types of passes are going to be open.
Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
Knowing there are guys on your team who know what you want and know what it takes to be successful is a big bonus.
First one is no good. Rims out.
Hey, you don't have to be a space eater, aka a big guy, to get on board. You just have to be relentless.
They work the perimeter. And the block. About 4 minutes remaining. That's a foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Well, Dick, here's a player in just his freshman year.
Hey, being a student in college is quite an experience, but being a student athlete is something on a whole other level. There are a lot of challenges you have to meet if you want to keep your balance and be successful.
There's a reason they're called free throws. The shooting guard gets the ball. Both teams looking to get things going here. Joyner handles the pass. He goes for three. Off the mark. Looking for a good shot. Lets it fly. He's taken too many, swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Number five receives the pass. Rejected. The glass and no good. The point guard with the ball. About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. On the right side. And it's heading out of bounds. No, great save. And here's a snapshot of how they fare in their conference.
I don't know a coach who doesn't want to be at the top of this list. Conference play is really important, especially towards the end of the season.
Number one comes in for his first go-around tonight, Dick.
I tell you, the offense doesn't miss a beat when this guy comes in.
Ten on the shot clock. For two, off the glass and no good. The Golden Hurricanes are a balanced team, playing both up-tempo and half-court style, Dick.
I think when you have balance, inside-outside scoring, tempo control, where you control the pace of the game, and that's what they try to do with their balance. They'll go fast, they'll go slow. They try to dictate tempo.
These guys have really been able to step it up so far, and they're putting together a very good team effort.
This team is playing great team basketball. They're making it really tough for the opposition. If they can't keep this up, they'll all be happy once the final buzzer sounds.
On the dribble, gives it up. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. They just can't find the open seams on the floor.
They're struggling to score right now.
We're at the two-minute mark.
Trying to go inside.
He attempts the jump shot. And yet another missed field goal attempt, Dick.
Wow, I'm speechless, Brad. And you know, that never happens. I don't know what to say. They couldn't be shooting the ball any worse.
They'll work it around the arc. He gets him to commit the charge.
He took one for the team, baby.
Number 14 gets his first sweat of the night.
Hey, it's important that this kid gets into the offensive action right away, Brad. He's going to make an instant impact.
He may be in some trouble here. Had a guy in the post, but elected to reverse the ball. They move it into the front court. Gets it back out. He wants a three.
If they can get off some good shots and easy buckets, it might turn around this awful stretch of shooting for them, Brad.
Easier said than done, though, right now, Dick. About a minute remaining in the game clock. Nails the J. There's a double team waiting there. Number 12 makes his debut into the game.
I tell you, this kid comes in with fire, Brad. He really knows how to bring it.
On the left side. Puts up the J. Scores it. Negatively influenced by his play and the events which have unfolded here.
Well, he knows he's not getting it done, and emotionally it's bringing him down.
Trying to feed the low block. He makes the block. Shot clock is dead.
Double team now, bad angle.
Goes up for two. Too strong. With no time left. Missed it. At the end of the first half, the Tigers lead by three. Tulsa carelessly gave away a lot of possessions by turning the ball over.
Their coaching staff must be livid right now. The amount of extra opportunities they're giving away is just absurd.
Number 23 is put back in the game.
Hey, this team easily comes apart without him out there, Brad.
Looks like they're going to go with a full court man-to-man press, Dick. Gave it up. Lobs it. Tries for two.
Good rebound. Great position on a rebound. could block out. Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break.
On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up with a shot. The missed shot. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside when they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Got it. Oh, that's charging.
Great defense, Brad.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
The Tigers now running a zone offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position. Pushing that basketball.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He tries the jumper. They got it. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Jumper, missed the jumper. You betcha. This guy can really score in a variety of ways down on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, he can beat you face up, or he can beat you with his back to the basket. He can step a few feet out, and he's been able to convert. He's a tough, tough matchup.
And we're at the 8-minute mark. Goes up. Nope.
I like the idea of having a glass cleaner on your team. Someone who can get those rebounds.
The center takes the feed. Oh, yes.
Their defense is absolutely horrible.
They are not putting up much of a fight. Did he get there?
Great anticipation by the young guy.
The Tigers have been getting it done with a number of players here, Dick.
I tell you what, they get an A for effort in my book so far, Brad. Sometimes that's the hardest thing to get from your team as a coach. When you have everyone on your team working together and playing hard, great things work out.
The Tigers move into their zone motion offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
He goes to the free throw line. He gets it to go. Going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
That trap could spell some trouble. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
What should they do here, Dick?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. About 7 minutes remaining. Throws it up.
He finished out with a beautiful alley-oop, Brad. Trying to get that ball movement with a good spacing.
Number 15 is charged with the foul. Third personal foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Another great sophomore right here, Dick.
Well, Brad, he's still mature. With your underclassmen, it's about improvement day by day, year after year.
This is the first. They're not getting the balls to fall from the line.
Hey, if I were the coach of this team, I would make them run so many lines, I would pass out from watching them run, Brad.
He hits the second shot. Gave it up. For the bucket. Nice shot. For two. Gets it to fall. He can't stay with him.
He's got to get some help from his teammates on D.
Nice drop step.
I tell you, he does a great job with his footwork to create the drop step.
Traps in place, Dick. Once again, let's take a look at our star watch. On the dribble, gives it up, goes up for two. It's good. Down to the low block, tries for two, can't connect. Working it around the perimeter. We're at the 5 minute mark. For the bucket, and he misses the shot. And a momentary look from 3-point land.
The freshman's a bit careless with the ball.
On the outside. Takes his jumper. Jumper won't go. Inside. We're at the 4 minute mark. Puts it on the floor and up and under. And come up short. Goes in. The Golden Hurricanes are going to have to make a move here and make a move fast. Playing in the half court is no longer an option, Dick. They've got to get some quick scores.
Hey, the clock nor the score is in their favor. They're going to have to switch up their style and play completely up-tempo. They should be looking to press and score quickly, Brad.
Time to pick up the defense here now. Shoots from the deep corner.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Turnaround jumper. Off the glass. About 3 minutes remaining. From the top of the circle.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his boards. And look at him running out there like Taco.
Number 15 is whistled for the foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
So he'll get an opportunity to change the scoreboard again from the free throw line.
Well, he created a foul opportunity. Makes those free throws count. Let's go back on that campus. It's BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
And it's knocked away. Great block. Ball's going to stay here. You know, Dick, this guy's really elevated his game today.
I tell you, no, he's been stepping it up, man. He's really come to play tonight. Take a look. What a great performance, Brad. I'll tell you, he's fun to watch.
Up with it. They don't seem to be getting any decent shot opportunities, Dick.
Because they're looking in the wrong places, Brad.
A little two-man action. Cross court. He goes up with it. Busts the jumper. We're at the two-minute mark. For two. Off the glass and no good. Goes up for two. Buried it.
Number five, 4-2.
Look at that spacing.
He attempts the trifecta. Off the mark. Joyner receives the pass. Puts up the jumper. Missed it. Tries for two. He rips the nets for another score.
He's absolutely unconscious.
The man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. Joyner handles the pass. Off the mark. Pushes it up. About a minute remaining in the game clock. Fed the low block. Memphis is now in the bonus.
I like it when a team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
And there they miss one. Dick, this team is having some serious problems at the free throw line.
And it's a collective effort by all of them tonight.
The missed shot.
Up and inside.
Change of possession. He tries the three. Buries the fadeaway. Trying to pack it inside. And now there's a whistle and a foul. Well, this is now one of the better free throw shooting teams in college basketball, that's for sure.
I'll tell you, team free throw shooting has got to be one of the most underrated statistics in basketball. It's a must if you want to win games at any level.
And he got them both. Gave it up.
Look at speed. I tell you, man, there's nothing like having athleticism and quickness. Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
Gets it. On the left side. On the dribble, gives it up. Number 23 is called for the foul. Second team foul. Horn steps to the line for the first time. He makes the first. Nothing but rim. Secures the board.
As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
And now let's take a look at our players of the game.
A real nice performance by both young guys. Some special players.